So it's time for another 2021 budget build. This time, I'm rolling with Team Blue. What's up, everybody? It's PJ the Great. I hope you're having a super beautiful day. And if you're new here, I do videos just like this, as well as tech reviews and gaming streams. So if that sounds like your jam, consider subscribing. And to all my returning subscribers, what's up, great ones? Welcome back. All right, so this is kind of like a follow-up video to the last video that I did about the $320 flipping gaming PC build. Well, this time I decided to roll with Team Blue because I just wanted to show everybody I'm not like a Ryzen Shield or anything like that. There is a good upgrade path if you go with Team Blue, which is Intel. So I'm gonna share that with you today. So we're gonna roll into the parts. Go into a little bit of gaming testing, and then we'll wrap this video up. So let's get into it. And you can see the gaming results right there. So let's talk a little bit about the parts and what my thoughts are on them. Now, just to give you a heads up, this is a build that you can do right now today for roughly around $450. Once again, just like in the Ryzen build, you're gonna have to do a little bit of lead work in order to get decent prices. So if you're willing to do that, then you'll run into that roughly $450 build. All right, so I wanna go into each individual part and what the upgrade path is and what I probably would have done differently. So let's start off with the CPU. So I use an Intel Core i3-8100T. That's a 8th generation part from Intel. And if you can, I would definitely go with the 10th generation Core i3-10100 instead, because you're gonna get hyper-threading with that. The Core i3-8100, of course, doesn't have any hyper-thread. It's only 4 cores, 4 threads. So I will go that route instead, unless you can find a Core i3-8100 for roughly around $80. That's what I think they should be going for. I paid $100 for mine, but that was like a year ago, and for some reason they're still going for that price. They're even going as high as like $200, which is ridiculous. So in this situation, if you can find it for $80, roll with it. But if you can't, then I highly suggest going the Core i3-10100 route instead. Now, with the way that this build is set up, it's on a motherboard that can support 8th gen and 9th gen Intel processors, so the upgrade path is great there, because you can move up to an i5 or an i7 in 8th gen or 9th gen, and it really does set you up for good room for like upgrade, like a really good upgrade path. So it's just as good as that Ryzen build that I talked about. As far as the RAM is concerned, I really wouldn't do anything different with the RAM. I installed 16 gigabytes of RAM. It's rated at 2400 megahertz, and it had a CAS latency. Say that fast. CAS latency. All right, got it. I think it was like 15. It was really good RAM. It was like generic RAM, just green, but the speeds were great. The Core i3-8100 can't handle anything more than 2400 megahertz, so that was perfect. And the one thing I love about the Intel platform is that it really doesn't care that much about RAM as much as Ryzen does. Like, I tested that RAM out on my Ryzen test bed, and the Ryzen went crazy for a while until it settled down. But RAM speeds really doesn't impact performance as much on the Intel side as the Ryzen side. So the RAM is good to go. As far as the storage is concerned, I would probably bump that 120 gigabyte SSD up to at least a 240 gigabyte SSD. I really don't foresee any issues with anyone doing the same build only having 120 gigabytes because it was paired with that 3 terabyte hard drive. So you just throw everything over there, like your games, your files, your music, so on and so forth. And 120 gigabyte SSD, just save that for Windows 10 and a couple of apps. And I don't foresee that being an issue at all. As far as the power supply is concerned, that's good. 450 watts, that'll be fine. I'll list like a 500 watt instead. They'll give you a little bit more breathing room. But for this particular build, 450 watts is just fine. And like I mentioned in the Ryzen build video, that you can go as high as a 2060 KO on the NVIDIA side or 5600 XT on the AMD side. Same with this, you'll be just fine. So I don't think there's anything wrong with power supply, especially I wouldn't go anything higher than that as far as graphics cards are concerned with the Intel Core i3-8100 anyway. So 450 watt power supply should be just fine. And then we'll move over to that graphics card. Now, graphics card prices are crazy right now because of the crypto mining boom that I wish will die already. I found that HD 7870 on eBay. Someone was selling it for $130. I put in an offer of $100 and they accepted. Me personally, I wouldn't pay anything more than $100 for this graphics card. It's good enough to get you by, as I showed in the gaming results. It really performs well in esports games, and then you can even get away with playing a couple of AAA titles if you're willing to lower the settings. I found the sweet spot to be somewhere around 900p and 1080p low settings, to where you'll get a really enjoyable experience until you can get your hands on a better GPU at better prices. And I really won't touch that much on the case because that is all based upon you and what you like in a case. I like that case, I think it's fine. But if you stay within that $30 price range, I'm pretty sure you can find either this case or a case that suits you better for around that price to keep you in that $450 budget. So the case, you can go any way you want. That's all aesthetics. So thank you very much for checking out this $450 bill. Let me know what you thought about it in the comment section down below. Let me know what you would have done differently, or if you plan to tackle this bill yourself in 2021. I think it'll be fine. I actually did some testing on it yesterday too that I forgot to mention. I was playing Phasmophobia with a couple of friends, and I decided to use this PC to do that with, and it played it just fine. So I don't see anything wrong with this being a starter PC that you can build up on within the future. So hey, if you like this video, do me a favor and give it a big old thumbs up. But if you hated it, you can give it a thumbs down. But no matter what you do, don't forget to click that subscribe button and click the bell right next to it so you'll be notified every time I upload new videos. And once again, thank you so much for checking it out. Sorry I missed the weekend of videos, but I'm gonna try to get back on the train again, as well as getting some gaming streams in there. So until I see you in the next video or stream, this is PJ the Great saying Audi 5000G. FYI, 15 minutes after listing that computer for sale, I sold it. I think I'm starting to get a little bug. Starting to get that Brian from Tech Yes City bug. I might start doing this more.